Hey everyone, Sean and Sav. And after our first season's event, we noticed that we have to tighten up that dispersion. And the tightening up of the dispersion, we're in the middle right now of a fantastic session on our premium channel. This is gonna be the third excerpt of that series. It's called the Kettlebell into Doorframe series. And you'll notice that to tighten up the dispersion, you really have to center the center of your swing, right? To steady the center of your swing. So when the center of your swing stays very quiet and very stable, then your contact and direction tighten up very dramatically. So we have a fantastic exercise that we're gonna do. We're gonna show you the kettlebell through the doorframe, and you'll see how you're going to be able to feel how to stay centered through the shots, and it's really gonna do a number on you, on the tightness in your dispersion. Stay with us. So we have a hammer to demonstrate the door frame. We got a 10-pound kettlebell. And what she's trying to do is stamp the face of this kettlebell through that door frame. So she's gonna do a little perpetual motion. That's what we call it, right? So if you swing back and through, so right now you feel like you can stamp it through that door frame very nicely, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so now set up next to the door frame and sway off the door frame. So right now you feel like there's no way you could use the weight of your arms and kettlebell to stamp that in.
No.
Now get way out in front of it. So doesn't that feel like you just, you know, went by your exit on the highway and you can't get back there?
Yeah.
So now show me where that is again. Stamp it a few times. Stamp. So do you feel how the legs are carrying your body out of the way to allow that kettlebell to come through?
Yeah.
Okay, so now when you take, what iron you got there?
Eight.
So you have an eight iron, and we're gonna use that tee as the door frame, right? So you're setting up right up against that tee, and now show me a backswing and stop. Does that feel like if you let the weight of your arms fall, it's gonna fall through the door frame and in that direction?
Yeah.
Let's see you sway off the ball. So doesn't that feel like you're going to hit the ground first and you won't be able to get back to it?
Yeah.
So now go to the top and stop. And now pretend you're going to be going after the ball and your head's going to move forward. Doesn't that feel like you just lost your exit?
Yeah.
Okay. So we have these two tees here that we put so that you can swing through the door frame in the direction of your target. Show me a ball position that'd be too far back in the stance. Doesn't that feel now you're the center of your body's way out in front of it?
Yeah.
Too far forward? Now you have to go after it?
Yeah.
So where does it feel like it needs to be so you just let it fall right through? There you go. That's right on the target that we wanted. So that felt more like you were letting it happen?
Yeah.
There was no interference in that?
No.
Okay. Oh, there it is. So that felt like there was an actual squeeze through that door frame in that direction.
Yeah.
So now let me see you take a seven wood to this now.
Okay.
Okay, so now when we have a seven wood, it's a much wider club. And the center of mass of that club is further back, so that's gonna nudge the ball a little more forward. So when you see Sav set up, imagine that door frame is there, and you'll see just how proportionate the center of her body is in relation to that door frame, okay? Now, one of the things that we're in the middle of in this series on the premium channel is the two swing series. So we got the kettlebell drill, but we're doing two swings in a row. We're catching the first ball with the first swing, and then we gotta make another swing after we hit that shot. So go ahead and demonstrate that, Sav. So two kettlebell swings in a row through the door frame. Wow. I don't think you could demonstrate that any better. So observe and stop action, what Sav just demonstrated there, and you'll see how tight that center was back and through. Because she had a second swing to perform, the brain is not going to go way out here, out in front, because there's a second swing to go do.
Yeah.
And so now that we were centered going through, bless you, now we're able to come back nicely. And because we have another swing to do, we're going.
Sorry.
That was too cute. So you get the gist. The two swing drill is what keeps you in the shot and keeps you centered. So we have a double whammy of centering that we're doing with this particular drill. So you got to get good at the door frame with the kettlebell.
Yeah.
Then you're going to use perpetual motion with the door frame and the kettlebell, and you really feel how active the legs are in getting you out of the way while you're staying centered. And then when you do the two swings with the rest of the club, so now let's do it with the driver.
Okay.
So extremely important, we're putting down two tees. There's a second tee there as the intermediate point. The intermediate point's got to be no more than a foot in front of the ball in your immediate peripheral vision. So when Sav gets up there and you look at it from down the line, you'll see the blur of the club if you do a couple of swings next to the ball. So set up next to the ball. Do you feel like the ball is in the proper place in relation to your kettlebell?
Yeah.
So does that feel like the club is staying nicely in that direction?
Yeah.
Okay. So come on in. So you're now ready to do two swings through the door frame in that direction?
Yeah.
All right. Nice. Nice. Notice how after the first swing took off, notice you caught the ball slightly on the way up. You just nicked the tip of the tee. And then the second one, you came back and nicked the tip of the tee and finished it off.
Yeah.
So now I'm going to show you guys the same thing, except right-handed, so you get the other point of view. Okay? Let's go. Okay. So kettlebell against the door frame first. Here we go. Boom. Right through. Now, if I veer off, now it feels like I can't get there. So if you're swaying off the ball, you'll feel right away how you cannot use the weight of the arms to get through. Got through, got through, got through. So if I want to use more weight with more intensity, it's the legs that are going to turbocharge this. So that takes care of that. Now I've got a little 7-iron here that I'm going to use through these two tees. They're going toward that yellow post. So I feel like I'm right up against the door frame and I can squeeze it through the door frame in that direction. Whereas, got to reach for it. Got to reach back for it. I can just let it go. So now I'm going to feel the weight of my kettlebell, and I'm just going to let it squeeze right through. And man, you saw the direction that that ball took off on, and look at the divot. See how I caught ball first. Here was the ball, and look where my divot is. So I'm staying with that squeeze through the door frame. Hands come through first, then shaft, then heel of club, collect the ball, squeeze through the door frame. So you can see that the low point is right there in front of the ball, just like in these shots that you're going to see here on tour. These are from some tour events. The second one is from Matt Kuchar. And just look at how the club strikes the ball first, then stays along the ground. The ball's long gone, and the club is still through the ground. So really, really important visual to have as you stay through that door frame. So if I have this as my door frame, And I'm going to do this in slow motion. Yes, I can squeeze it. Still squeeze. Still squeeze. So now it feels like I'm squeezing through and out toward that picture. So let's look at that three wood now. So same thing. The low point of the three wood, when I stay with it, is out here in front. You'll see this again. Here's a fairway wood. You can see the club coming down, catch the ball, continue down as the club goes, the ball goes in the air before it comes back up. Comes back up a little sooner only because the ball position's a little more forward, okay? So I got to reach back. I got to reach forward. I feel like I can squeeze it through. So you see that position there? So that feels like I can squeeze it through parallel to those tees that are on the ground. Now I'm just going to use the weight of that kettlebell. And then we're squeezing it through. And that was like 5 yards left of my target, just a hair thin. And so I'm super happy with that. Nice contact. So I'm going to switch my eyes to the grass instead of the ball. And then I'm going to go through the grass with the sole of the club. There it is. Hear that sound? So if we're going to do two in that direction with that sound, so for those of you who have a tendency to catch a middle thin or top the fairway woods, get your mind on the sole of the club along the ground, and then you'll see that the contact with the face is going to really improve. So I am skipping along those tees twice in that direction with the weight of my arms and club. Bingo. There it is. So we've had driver for accuracy, where we're using the sole of the club to follow the surface of the ground, and we're teeing up the ball in a way where the ball is just barely above the equator of the ball, or the equator of the club, I should say. So this time, I'm going to tee it up in a way where the ball is a little bit higher, because I like to take advantage of my carries. So I'm going to feel like I'm moving up through the door frame. So let's look at how this is going to look. There's my door frame. So instead of through the door frame, I'm going to play it just a hair more forward and feel like I'm stamping up through the door frame. Up, up, up. If I move forward, that's down. You will feel this right away. So for those of you looking for more carry distance, you want to optimize your numbers, this is a major golden nugget, okay? So we feel like it's slightly up. If it's too far forward, you're going to top it on the way up. If it's just right, you feel like it's just clipping the tip of the tee on the way up. And if it's too far back, you'll feel like you're going underneath the ball. And therefore, you'll have to lower the tee and hit the low bullet. So we take that out of there. I've got my intermediate point going in the direction I want to. I got a nice window in the clouds there over the trees. So this feels like, I'm going to play a little fade here. So this feels like I'm going a little left of the intermediate point, and it feels like I'm stamping through the door frame with the weight of my arms. I'm sandwiching the ball between the club and the door frame with weight, not force. Oh, that is sweet. Just a hair more to the right than what I wanted. It was just around the red post and very, very long. I know you heard the sound of that one. That was extremely satisfying. So let's just do one more now with the two swing drill. So I'm going to squeeze up into that window two in a row. Left of the intermediate point, right up in that window, squeeze it up into the window, weight only, twice in a row. Oh, man, look at that. That was pounded. So very, very pleased and very, very effective in feeling how centered you're going to stay, both with the two swing drill and with the kettlebell against the door frame. And then we bring that through the whole bag. All right. Enjoy that. Enjoy that fine tuning. We'll see you next week.